Welcome on back, everyone, to another episode of the Car Mechanic Simulator. You remember last time we are going to be working on the Edgewood Hellcat. Three pages of parts that are not found, and if I remember correctly, we couldn't get the engine started, I believe. Let's see if we can get that engine started. V8 wires are fine. Or did we get started? Let me see here. Now that I think about it, I think we did get it started, but we couldn't find anything wrong with it because it was mostly like, yeah, it was the belts and that in the front and the cross. Yeah, okay. So we did test it. We did on the last episode. So, let's start tearing this thing apart then. I see we're going to have to do the oil. So I'm going to take it that even the oil filter is going to be on that list. What we're going to do. Let's drain the oil out of this thing. We're going to work from the bottom and work our way up a little bit. Okay, first things first. Tear off these tires. That rubber bushing's gone. All of this has to be disconnected. Anything that's connected to the cross member's got to go. Cross member E. Okay. I just want to pull this off just to see something. Yeah, that's got to come out. I had a feeling something was more up than what was put on. So all of our parts that are pretty much broke is in the engine. Hands down. They're all in the engine. Alright, so that means all of this has got to go off. got to tear it all the way down. So what is it? Just the valve push rods that are broke? No rocker arms so far. None of them are broke. So it doesn't look like, let me pull this off too real quick. It doesn't look like the camshaft broke. Yeah, I don't think the camshaft broke at all. I'll pull it off though, just in case, you know. Yeah, never know. Work our way down. Yeah, so, weird enough, I don't think any of the rocker arms have any problems at all. It's literally all the valve push rods that are broke. Most of the time, I just renew everything when it comes to certain stuff, like I said probably before. Obviously, the push rods, we'll do all 16 of them. Spark plugs, if there's anything broke, I'm just going to do all 8 of them because they're cheap. Like, they're not a lot of money. If they were a lot of money, then I could, yeah, I probably wouldn't do it. Alright, so the camshaft doesn't even need touch. So we have to pull off the pistons because we have to get the crank out. So even though they're not broke, but we still got to pull them. Okay. There's the crank. All right. So that is all of them. Another test. Didn't we do that on the last episode? I swear to God, we did that on the last episode. Anyway, we'll do it again. We're going to write all this down. I swear we did it. Maybe not, though. I'm getting old. I swear we did it, though. Four of those. Serpentine A and B. B8OHV. Starter V8, we already have that. It's just not on. We don't need to rebuy that. And all the valve pushes. 16 of those, I want to say. So, let's go in here. We need the clutch plate out of that. Right, we're going to go over here. We need cam gear right here. I think that's it out of this. Crank. We need a crankshaft. V8. Where are you? Right here. And we need all three bearing caps. Engine head. We need the V8 ones over here too. I think two of the same there. Front suspension, we need E. Oil is the V8. We need four rubber bushings. We'll put them on first before we put on anything else because they'll literally go on any of the lower suspensions. We don't, so yeah, we got to do it. 15A. A. There's B. Timing chain. That and the valve, we need 16. I didn't see any spark plug. No, I thought there was a spark plug that was broke. I must be seeing shit. I swear there was a spark plug broke. Like Ginger Bear, you have been seeing too many parts in your sleep. Okay, see these? That's what I was talking about. If I do them first, it's gonna take my hundreds first. I'm not gonna do that. I'm gonna go around the ones that are broke. Now we'll do all the rest. We gotta go up top, start putting all that together. Alright, go down in the middle here, put this in. And that opens up all of these we have to put in now. I That's some work. These cars take a little bit of work because all of these rockers, man, they take forever. They are the longest engines to do, I swear. Like I said, way earlier, a couple episodes ago, there is some that are aftermarket or they're cross seas, those kind of cars. Oh, man. There are some weird cars that you have to work on. I never seen those kind of cars until this kind of video game and stuff like that. So, like, I never seen them in real life. But I would hate to work on something like that. I would not want to have that job. Like, in real life, I think the weirdest kind of engine that I personally have seen is a Mitsubishi. Those cars, oh my god. I swear all the parts on that are on backwards. Like, you literally, their left is right, their right is left, and it's just everywhere. It's you can definitely tell it's not from around here made. I was like, nope, don't want nothing to do with that engine. All right, is that everything? No, it's not. What am I doing? Almost put the oil in it without an oil pan. That'd have been fun. All right, wheel alignment. We need to move the car over to the test path again. I know we did this. That's it. Coolant. bigger question would be right now is how did I get the car from the garage into the test path without no coolant or anything? I guess we just overheated the engine. I don't know. Anyway. Alright. Another level. Got 7 points now. Let's use it right here. So we can now give the ability to inspect the value of a car. So if we go in anywhere, we can, make ourselves faster too. We're gonna have to unlock some. We can unlock this. Salvaging is over there. I don't ever use this, but you can. Let me show you how. See what I mean? How you do it. Want to try to get to the big bonus. Sometimes you can, sometimes you can't. That's how fast you are. But I believe there is an achievement for this, I believe. I'm not mistaken. Yeah. You can sit here and do that. If you want to salvage them, I don't know what exactly that does yet, because I am new to this game, just like all of you. So once I figure that out, I will let you all know, because believe me, we will figure it out. I'll let you know in the next episode. Because I am going to have to look that up myself. Let's go over here. The next one in here. And this one looks like it's going to be some work. Oh boy. Let's first take... I literally should just take all these to the car wash every time. Now let's go to A. Oh, it don't look that bad. Our status, replace body parts, spray the factory so we have to paint it, increase the tuning of the car. Form the wheel alignment. I think the tuning has to be done in the dyno, so we might have to buy the dyno. No. I'm wrong. I am wrong. the tuning has to be done by putting higher performance parts in the car. That's what you got to do. Yeah. We have to put higher performance parts in this car, so we have to buy stuff from another catalog inside the parts store. Instead of that, we have to buy parts from this. Higher performance parts. Make the car go vroom vroom faster. Okay, so what can we do to, real quick? Let me see if I can run the machine. Yep, all right. Oh, that's good news. At least we know we don't got to go to the bottom now. Alright. So, I'm looking at it. Like, some rims has got to go off of this. Definitely rims. I would say these belts have got to go, too. Fuel filter doesn't look that good. That air filter's got to go. So... what is the other task? Change brake fluid, power steering. All right, guys, before we get too excited here and start rolling on this car, that is going to be it for this episode. As you can see, we're probably going to have to replace these parts here that are red. I'm going to take it. And we're going to have to change some tires and rims. And there's some wear and tear parts under it that we already seen from down below. Looks like the drive shaft parts and all that are gone. So that will be the next episode of the Car Mechanic Simulator. Thank you all for hanging out. If you're not subbed, hit that subscription button. I greatly appreciate it. All the links are down below. Follow me everywhere and anywhere. If you're into reading, I do write horror books, so you can get them too. They're really cheap. So, have a good one. I'll catch you on the next episode. Take care.